Hey everyone, welcome back to Danganronpa. As you may have already guessed, today we are looking at the school mode. And I do have a guide open, which I will hopefully be cross-referencing a few times to make sure that we're on the right track. At least for now, when I look at the guide, I don't really know what the heck they're talking about without looking at the mode itself. So let's just jump right in. Oh wow. Dangan Academy! Purely prismatic souls! Oh, I'm sorry. Enchanting Dangan Academy! Alright. Well, clearly I've pressed into this before. Oh, my dear god. No difficulty. The massive high school towers over all the other buildings in this bustling urban area. It's like the school stands at the center of the entire world. Hope's Peak Academy. It's trying to trick you into thinking it starts out the same way. It brings in top students from every field imaginable. A government-funded school of privilege. They say that if you come here and manage to graduate, you'll be set for life. With hundreds of years of tradition, it sends the cream of the crop into the workforce every year. Okay, so since we've seen all of this before, I'm not really gonna read every word. Maybe just the stuff that we haven't seen before. Gonna be a little bit more casual because my throat. Yep, we have to attend high school, be really good at what we do. Same as the very beginning so far. Yep. Go to the hall, but this time probably you're not gonna lose your memory, right? Oh no. My view became warped and twisted. It was like some kind of delusion melting away and mixing together into something else. Oh! Oh my god, even the little dialogue thing is different. Makoto, are you okay? Huh? What? Were you like trying to escape into your own reality? It's not like any of us know what's going on either. No, actually, this is Mukuro Ikusaba. Oh, I'm sorry. There's no need to apologize. Given the situation, it's understandable. That's right. For some reason, I went unconscious as soon as I stepped into the main hall. And when I woke up, I was in the classroom. The windows were all blocked off by these weird metal plates. But it wasn't just the classroom, as it turns out. Everybody had our stuff taken away, and we were locked inside. An announcement came on asking us to come to the gym for the entrance ceremony. But hearing that voice made it hard to concentrate. Hey, where are the others? Wasn't everyone here earlier?
Oi.
Everyone else went to the gym while your ass was knocked out. Ah, this is so strange, seeing all these people alive again.
Hello.
But is it really a good idea to obey such a strange announcement?
Yeah.
Yeah, it was weird as hell. But what else are we supposed to do? She's right. Whatever is going to happen, standing our ground here isn't going to stop it. Okay, let's head to the gym. Makoto, are you good to go? Yeah. I was forced to wonder what the hell was going on here. I was tormented by a dark feeling of foreboding, but I did my best to ignore it and hurried to the gym. So if I remember correctly, this is like, the beginning is the same, but there's not gonna be any sort of murdering. It's gonna be more like, let's work together and get out of here, kind of thing. And as soon as I entered, a weirdly cheery voice echoed across the room. It's a lot more welcoming this time too. We have chairs! Well, this part's not welcoming. Such a bright voice and carefree attitude was completely out of place.
Oh, can't do it! It just can't be done!
Huh?
This entrance ceremony was supposed to be your chance to make your big high school debut! As the headmaster, I did my best to put on a happy face, but... It's just impossible! You can only lie to yourself for so long, you know? But if you can't do it, you can't do it! I've lost my confidence, my groove, and there's no getting it back!
Hell? Why is he acting so depressed? I went from terrified to annoyed in no time flat! Wait, is that a teddy bear? That teddy bear can talk!
Come on, what kind of cliched reaction is that? You people just keep on reacting the same way.
It's just making me more and more depressed.
Even if the hardware is backwards compatible, I guess the same doesn't go for the characters.
Oh?
Humans are so stupid, worse than any piece of software. I'm just getting lower and lower, and there's rock bottom. Here comes the Earth's core.
This whole thing just feels sloppy as hell.
Oi.
You expect us to believe you're the headmaster? Stop screwing around.
You're right, I screw around too much. I've spent half my life apologizing for the other half of my life. But I've been spending so much time trying to think of what to make you guys do, and I'm just lost. Meanwhile, I've been totally neglecting myself. Trying to laugh it off now would just be another lie.
Where the heck is this going? I don't know. You've been neglecting yourself? What does that even mean?
I forgot to do something that was gonna be a vital part of your greeting today. What the heck? My stomach's starting to hurt from all this self-loathing.
He seems really depressed. What is it you think he forgot? I don't think that matters. All that matters is finding a way out of here. No! I need to know! Tell us, what did you forget? If necessary, you should cancel the entrance ceremony and take the time to prepare a proper one.
You're right! What I forgot was my backups!
Backups for what?
For me! Duh!
Backups for you? What?
I don't understand what you don't understand. A backup, a spare, and in case of emergency.
Okay, we get it. Oh, hey, Leon. So if you can have backups, does that mean you really are a toy or a robot or whatever?
Yeah.
If I understand what he's saying, that would make sense.
No, see? Oh, okay, I got it. I don't like to admit this, but... Yes! I'm a robot so advanced, even the folks at NASA can't recreate or even comprehend it.
Come on!
But I don't have any backups, so I can't begin!
Huh? What can't you begin? The entrance ceremony?
Sure, that too. But even more than that, I can't even begin your school life itself! Without a backup, the first time I break, that'll be the end of everything for you guys.
Oi, oi.
I don't think any of us give a shit if you break or whatever.
Be stupid! Without a headmaster, how can your life here run smoothly?
But did you not say that you are so advanced even NASA cannot comprehend it? So you should not break so easily, am I right? Yeah, boost its ego.
You guys are gonna break me! You blew me up in the prologue last time and tore me apart in Chapter 5!
Huh? Prologue? Chapter 5? What's he talking about? Ha 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 ha!
But anyway, let's not worry about that. Before we can begin your school life here, I'm gonna have you guys build me some backups.
Huh?
What? Oh man, come on! What's he even talking about?
Boy.
You think you can give me orders, you living garbage?
I do! And while you're at it, I'll have you add a bunch of awesome bonus features. Like make me super handsome or eco-friendly, that kind of modern trendy feel. Or it might be good for a Japanese-style mascot like me to have a super cutesy, super moe backup.
What the hell, man? You're talking like we already agreed to help.
Well, you're gonna, right? It's important that you grow a student, sure, but... You also have the opportunity to help your teacher grow.
You think fake inspirational crap like that is gonna get us on your side? I don't think he's listening. He's just creating his own reality as he goes. Man, if this is the kind of bizarre crap I can expect as a new student here, I'm just gonna go home.
And how do you plan to do that? You saw the metal plates covering all the exits, didn't you?
So we really have been imprisoned in here. What the hell is this? Why would you trap us in here? Let us the hell out of here! He said he does not have a backup, yes? Why don't we just destroy this one right now? Just 2 minutes ago, Celeste was like, "Oh, you're like the best robot ever, even NASA doesn't get you." Now she's like, "Let's break him."
So it finally occurred to you. But I won't go out that easily. I'll use my NASA-level technology to run and hide and you'll never find me.
You seem like a monumental waste of technology. Alright, that's it! Not gonna be a part of whatever shitty joke you're trying to pull here. Yeah, who gives a shit about some backup or whatever? We're not here to take care of you.
Okay, yeah, sure, I see what you're saying. Then, would you rather just start killing each other?
What? Huh? What did you just say? I believe he said something about us killing each other. Oh, thank you, Sakura. I didn't hear that. Killing? What are you talking about? If that's supposed to be a joke, it's not funny. It's just stupid. Yeah, even if you're just trying to make a point, that's taking it too far. Come on, stop trying to freak us out just to get us to do what you want. Just hurry up and let us out of here.
Would you guys please stop nagging me? I wanna go home! I thought bears were crazy about our homing instinct, but you guys really take the cake! But I guess you can't really help yourselves. You're all part of that new wave enlightenment generation. You need a specific goal to motivate you. Well then, here's a little spoiler.
Spoiler?
Once the backups are done, we'll move on to the main event and you can begin your exciting school life. Once that starts, then you'll have the chance to trigger your escape flag.
What are you talking about? Speak plainly. I thought of all people, you and Hifumi would understand what he's saying. I don't know what he means, but he did just say something about escaping, right?
See? I was totally clear. If you want to escape, you'll have to live here peacefully and build me my backups. And you can't just half-ass it either. Build me a superior machine with flawless performance that thrills and delights me, and you pass. And don't worry about living expenses. You have all the food, clothing, and shelter you need. I can even personally guarantee your health and safety. Even if you get sick or injured, I'll treat you right away in the Monokuma Emergency Center.
I don't think that's what we're worried about. Why did we have to do all this in the first place?
Whatever! Stop complaining and just do it! Now then, with this, the entrance ceremony hasn't even begun! I mean, you haven't even started your real school life yet! So, obviously I can't welcome you yet, which means this isn't a proper entrance ceremony. Okay, I'm done talking for now. Please enjoy these ever-fleeting days of peace!
Without another word, he was gone, leaving us in a dazed confusion. So, how would you explain what the heck just happened? Yeah, what the hell was that? I'm totally lost. We're trapped here, right? And if we make some backups, then we can get out? That seems to be the gist of it. If you think about everything that this Monokuma told us, you will notice there are two main points. The first point is that we're trapped in the school. And the second, more important point. If we can create backups for him to his satisfaction, he will tell us how to escape from the school. But one thing we do not know is why he wants us to do this at all. What was his purpose in imprisoning us in here in the first place? Yeah, what happened to Hope's Peak Academy? Did it get taken over by some evil organization or something? If that's the case, I'm sure the police will be here anytime. But can we even be sure that this really is Hope's Peak? Listen, I'm sure this is all just some kind of elaborate orientation setup. They're like hazing us. Orientation? But if that's true, it's in pretty bad freaking taste. It's total overkill. Oh. He's right. If it's a prank, it's far beyond the bounds of acceptability. Okay, fine. In that case, what is going on? That's what we're trying to figure out. You know, if he didn't forget to build those backups of his, what do you think he would have made us do? I don't think you want to know. Kill each other. That's what he said. Whoa. Don't freak us out, dude. Who the hell would ever? Everyone, just calm down. He said we'll have plenty of food and shelter and we'll be kept safe. So that's good, right? If we want to get out of here, we all need to work together. I fucking hate the idea of being at the mercy of that goddamn bear. Well, what else can we do? Total pain in the ass either way. That I would lower myself to serving that monstrosity. But it seems our best option is to calmly adapt ourselves to this new situation. If this truly is something that Hope's Peak has put together for us, then I am fine with that. If that is not the case and Hope's Peak has been taken over by some other force, it would be best not to blindly oppose them. It gives me chills to think I'll have to live here along with you unwashed masses. Well, whatever. I'll just have to make sure to finish things quickly. And then I'll find whoever did this to me and wipe them from the face of Earth. Okay, well, does anyone have any objections? Silence gives consent, as they say. Not in all cases. Then it's decided. From this point forward, we all agree to work together to maintain a peaceful communal life. Sure. When I first got into Hope's Peak Academy, I thought, man, I can't believe I get to go to this amazing place. But wherever I am now, it's 180 degrees away from whatever amazing place I've made up in my mind. And that's how our bizarre communal life began. Can I just say that having 15 people alive is so bad for my throat, holy shit. Reading all the lines becomes so much more difficult, but anyways. Once all that was done, we moved from the gym to the dining hall to talk about our future here. But when he says we have to make him some backups, what exactly are we supposed to do? Yeah, he didn't explain any of the important bits.
That was just for convenience's sake.
Now he's here?
Sure, I could have explained everything in the gym, but if I'd gone on any longer, it would have been totally annoying, right? It would have been like, hey, hurry up and start already.
I'm not sure I agree with that.
So, let me explain right now. I'm gonna give you guys the next 50 days to make a proper set of backups.
50 days? That's like forever! Why so long?
That's for convenience's sake, too. You guys would totally slack off if you didn't have a time limit. Humans give in so easily to corruption.
Okay, but what about this whole backup thing? You said you wanted a bunch of bonus features, but but it's super vague!
I thought you might say that. So from time to time, I'll give you a special concept. You can use that to design the next backup.
What? Can't we just make one and be done with it?
Of course you can't just make one and be done with it! Who knows what kind of violence you guys might commit against poor old me? I need all the help I can get! Heck, just a second ago you were talking about how you should just destroy me right now! I heard you! You wanna...
Is this really necessary? Fake, cry all you want. We're not gonna fall for it.
Fake?
No,
I really am sad. All your heartless comments have made me sad. But your teacher won't let it get to him. No matter what, I'll put you all on the right path.
Oy, oy. And the right path would be...
Oh, yeah! To keep you all from slacking off, I'll be performing project reviews as you progress.
Project reviews?
What, never heard of a project review? Want me to write it down for you?
No, I know what it is. It's meant to check our progress. So you're going to be checking up on us to see how things are coming. That's just common sense! Yeah, it's totally common sense. I feel like I want to die right now.
Okay then, hurry up and get to work! I'm as excited as the rest of you to get through this and begin your real school life.
But, if we fail our project review, is there some kind of punishment?
Well...
Here it comes.
No, nothing in particular.
What? Don't scare us like that.
You know?
There's no punishment, but if you can't do it, you won't trigger that escape flag I mentioned. Plus, if you pass, I'll give you something super awesome. What is it? Well, you'll just have to get it and find out! But it's super fun, I promise! Now then, are you ready for your first assignment?
Okay, let's cool it with the voices for a bit, because I am just exhausted now. Okay, the concept for the very first backup. Monokuma Casanova. Okay. Make a Monokuma Casanova? What does that even mean?
Exactly what it says. You know what a Casanova is, right? I want a good-looking version of me.
You're looking? You're a bear. Oh. We better not think about it too hard or we'll never get anywhere. Anyway, how are we even supposed to start building something like that? Yeah, I mean, where are all the materials or whatever?
I can't do everything for you. Look around the school yourselves for whatever you might need. Oh, but as an extra special service, I will give you some materials just this once. I figure you could use at least a little practice before you start on the real thing. Okay, so here you go!
Marble slab, aluminum can, chisel. Thanks.
Maybe I'll have you start by using these materials to make a Greek statue. And after that... if you combine this with the Greek statue, I think you'll wind up with a truly ravishing Monokuma.
Bring it to me the absolute instant you're finished. No pit stops.
Okay, have a nice day!
I don't even... okay, well... Okay, so according to the guide I read, in school mode, we can fill up everyone's report cards, right? And then if we do that, we can see each character's endings. I don't really know what that means, but apparently we can see people's endings. And the first playthrough, if the objective is to try to fill in all the report cards, then we should focus on building cheat sheets and cleaning maestros. Because apparently, materials that we gather in one playthrough won't carry over to the next, but gathering and cleaning levels gained by the classmates will carry over, so it's better to have higher levels now and then save it for a subsequent playthrough so that we can construct faster or something like that. So let's see here. Setting tasks. I can't set tasks. Okay, so we have to construct. Select construct and make a Monokuma Casanova. Okay. We need a Greek statue. How do we... what is even going on? Greek statue. Okay, we made a Greek statue and now we can make a Monokuma Casanova. Oh, so handsome.
A Casanova's supposed to be good looking, right? Is this good looking? Subjective opinions aside, you created the backup and completed the assignment, so let me give you some tickets.
Ooh, I don't know what this is.
I'll explain how they work later, so make sure not to throw them away. So, now do you get how to do it?
If this is all there is to it, this is gonna be a breeze. Indeed, I'm sure we can handle this. Even if we don't get it right the first time. With enough practice, I'm sure we'll get the hang of it and figure everything out.
You seem pretty confident. Maybe I spoiled you a little too much. But there's nothing I can do about that. I'm just so sweet and kind and sincere.
Yeah.
So now you're ready to gather your own materials, right? You can handle that much, right?
Hi.
Well, even if you decide you can't, I'm not gonna help you anymore.
Yes.
We don't need your help. We're all gonna work hard and do our best and make your stupid backups and get out of here. Glad to see you getting all fired up, but don't overwork yourself, or I'll be the one who ends up taking care of you. Take plenty of breaks, drink lots of fluids, promise me you'll be safe and make your teacher proud.
You don't have to remind us. We have no desire for you to take care of us.
Also, make sure you keep everything clean. If you can't do it yourselves, I'll make you do it.
Hi.
This is where you live, right? You need to put in the effort to keep it nice and tidy.
What a pain in the ass. Well, to be fair, cleaning is part of the normal school life.
Okay, your next project review is coming up.
Okay, next concept is the same thing, do it right this time. 5 days left. Okay, how does this work? Assign chores to each character. Each person can engage in one of the three activities: collect, clean, or rest. Okay, yeah, okay, okay. Each person has three stats. HP, if this reaches zero, they won't be able to act for 3 days. So, a bad thing. Collection level and cleaning level, right. Those are the things that carry across the playthrough, so we need to focus on increasing both of those to max, which is 9. Oh, check out those cute little icons there. Oh, everyone's so cute. Okay. Alright. So, let's see here. Can we close this? Okay. So, can we go back here? I just want to see. The thing that we should be getting, I think it's a consumable? Cheat sheet and cleaning maestro. That's what we need to be focusing on getting. Forget about the building the Casanova or whatever. We're just gonna give up on that stuff. Right, so apparently in the first playthrough, you're not gonna be able to finish the concepts no matter how hard you try. So it's really focusing on trying to fill out the report cards, and then we can think about actually doing the concepts next time. Of course, if we're gonna play that many times, there's gonna be repeat stuff, so when it starts repeating a lot, I'm probably not gonna show everything. But for now, let's see here. I think it should be okay to make everyone gather, collect stuff. So there's cleaning, and then the rest of this is gathering. Oh, but some places make HP go down more. Oh, I wonder why. Well, I'm guessing a certain amount of materials can only be found in certain places though, right? So we should send someone there all the time. But people will need to rest really quickly. The people that go to the later places. Oh, and everyone already has a little bit of level right now. 2 or 3. Some people are better at cleaning, some people are better at gathering, but we don't need any cleaning right now because we're at full. I'm just randomly doing this. I have no, like, I don't know what I'm doing. HP. Oh, maybe we should get some people to get some of the guys, put in the work, guys. I want someone in every room, pretty much. That's fine, that's fine. Okay, let's just give this a try then. I don't know what I'm doing, really. Oh! Everyone's gathering and they're finding lots of... Oh, yeah, that's good. Hopefully we can get enough materials to make some cheat sheets and all that good stuff. Alright.
It looks like you're really working hard. Well, right now, it's time for free time. Do whatever you want. Even a strange, childish little boy like you might stumble upon some bittersweet love if you're lucky. You can also use the trip tickets I gave you to go adventuring with your friends. Although, spending all this time building your friendships and deepening your bonds, it might just make things that much harder later on, you know?
Thanks, man. I know you're busy having fun and all, but do you have a second? Monokuma touched on it just now, but... At this point, you can now spend time with whoever you like. However, as these scenes play out, you'll notice they're exactly the same as in the main game. So you might notice people talking about having to kill each other. I know that seems strange, but... This is school mode after all. It's a bonus in addition to the main story, so we were too lazy to fix this shit. So please keep that in mind and try not to judge us too harshly. Anyway, take your time to explore and enjoy. Yeah, okay. Spend some time alone? What does that even mean? Wait, does go meet someone? Go meet with someone? Spend the ticket? Who should I talk to? Oh, how convenient. Everyone's just lying around here. Lying around here. Standing around here. So, oh. The hell?
What? You wanna go on a date with me? What should I do? I'm so embarrassed, but still... No, I can't! I don't go out with guys just because they talk to me nice. What kind of bear floozy do you think I am? But hey, since you came all this way to talk to me, I'll give you something extra special. Because you know what? I can see it. I can see how much everyone likes you. It's a special service for those of you who just can't have fun unless you can see all the numbers. But there's another side to the coin. You'll also be forced to see who doesn't like you. Are you sure you can handle it? Boop boop boop! Okay then, let's take a little peek.
Oh god, that's... Well, nobody really gives a shit about me at all right now, right? Because we didn't do anything yet.
Yeah.
Are you unhappy with the results? Well, if you want people to like you better, why don't you use a trip ticket and show your buddy a good time? What I'm saying is, you gotta curry that favor. But it doesn't matter how smoothly things go, if you can't get to your pal's deepest spots, then you'll be able to face each other and confess all your darkest, most awesomest secrets!
Right, so this seems to be... I'm not sure if this is the ticket place, or is it like regular report card building? It's a lot of information, but I think I remember reading that the tickets don't count for report cards, like how much the characters like you? I don't even know anymore. But anyway, in terms of what order to go in, I was thinking we should go in the order of the people that died. Because that's pretty arbitrary, there's no reason for it, I just want to do it that way. Which means we should go back to Sayaka first. Which I think is fair, because we've spent a lot of time without her, so... Hey! What would you like to do with Sayaka? Nothing, never mind. Spend some time together? Ooh, art room. This is strange because Sayaka can't even go to the art room in the main game. Are you going to try and cheer me up? Sorry for making you take time out of your day like this. I did my best to comfort Sayaka. Yeah, I remember reading this. Sayaka and I grew a little closer. Yes, let's give a present. By the way, I was rolling the machine and I ended up getting all of the presents except for the last 14, which I assume we're gonna get in the mode here, because 14 just seems to be way too convenient of a number. But then let's see. Let me go confirm what Sayaka likes, because I don't want to screw this up. Oh, you know what the funny thing is? Remember how a long, long time ago I was gonna give Sayaka the love status ring, but I didn't? She actually likes that, so we can give her that now. To receive something so wonderful makes me happy, but... To get it from you, Makoto, I can't begin to describe the feeling! Seeing Sayaka so pleased makes me happy! Listen, may I ask you just one question? So polite again, what's going on? And so polite again, I'd like to ask. Do you have a girlfriend? Wow, you're straightforward. What? That's like, way out of nowhere! Huh? Are you embarrassed? Does that mean you do? No, I don't! A girlfriend? Not at all! Then, do you at least have a crush on someone? Just wait a second! What's going on here? Why are you asking all these questions? I was just curious, so I thought I'd ask. Is that bad? No, kind of refreshing actually. It's not that it's bad, but I mean, if I don't know you too well, then it's kind of weird. Because it's only natural I'd be curious, right? Because because we're classmates going through the same thing together. Oh, what a disappointment. Classmates. Although, that's not all there is to it. You and I are more than just classmates. More than that? We're friends! We've been friends since middle school, in a way. That's true. Yeah, we're friends, of course. So, aren't you gonna ask me? Huh? What? Do you have a boyfriend? No, not what. Aren't you going to ask if I have a boyfriend or not? Well, for anyone who knows anything about Japanese idol culture, you would know that the answer should be a solid no. Putting ethics aside for a second, Japanese idols are not allowed to date anybody, so it should be a no. I mean, it's not like I don't want to know. Of course I want to know. You're really popular, right? So I wouldn't be surprised if you did. Nope, I definitely don't. The truth is, I'm way too busy for things like that. Then, do you have a crush on someone? I wonder. Is she like really blatantly hitting on me? Let's just say there's someone I'm interested in. Oh my god! Wait! Hey, your time has passed, okay? I'm all about Kyoko now. Stop trying to... Stop it! Sayaka stared straight into my eyes. I could swear her cheeks were tinged with red. Wait, me? But I need to put those feelings aside for now. Getting out of here is all that matters. Yeah, you're right. Whoa, doesn't this just make Sayaka seem like... I don't know, of all the people, she could avoid killing the... Actually, she couldn't, because if she actually escaped, then everyone else would die. But I mean, she could avoid framing her crush, but she decided to intentionally frame the crush. That's a little bit... Let's get out of here together, Makoto. No matter what. Please don't turn your back on me, okay? I don't know how to feel about this. Of course! I would never turn my back on you. I want you to know something, Makoto. And I want you to know that I mean it. I can't fake my feelings. I'm really glad you're here. This is so bittersweet and just confusing to hear. When she smiled at me like that, I could feel my entire body filling with power. It was like her smile was a source of pure energy. My friendship with her is my one source of courage. Yeah, remember back then, Makoto didn't have any friends yet. My bond with her makes me stronger. So I have to do my best in here. For myself and for Sayaka. I'm so happy you're gonna do your best for me. What? You heard me? She's an Esper. Like I said, I'm psychic. Kidding, I just have really good intuition. But is that really what you were thinking? Well... Anyway, let's just help each other out and get out of here no matter what it takes. I'm gonna do my best for sure. Yeah, you're right. We need to work together and do our best. I'm gonna do my best. I carved those words into the walls of my soul. Sayaka's report card. And I guess Sayaka's report card is done because... Yeah... There were only like 2 pages in her report card. After vowing to Sayaka to give it my all, I went back to my room. Actually... Oh, is that it? Okay. Work hard. Yeah, I was just gonna say, the fact that you get... the achievement for finishing Sayaka's report card, doesn't that mean it's a potential spoiler? Because I guess you can use length of report card to see if someone's gonna die soon, right? So that would have been a little fishy. Well, guess I have no choice but to show you how friggin' serious I can get! Mondo seems to be feeling pretty good. Okay, what was that? I don't know what that was! Oh, okay, so Mondo's feeling extra powerful today for some reason. Okay, sweet. So let's make Mondo do a lot of stuff. Let's make Mondo do the hardest thing. Go to the gym. Everyone else, they're still okay, right? The HP. These people are not as okay. So maybe you guys might want to chill a bit. Cleaning? We don't need to clean yet, so let's not. Let's switch out the people who are working at the hard areas and switch them with people who are not working at the hard areas. Yeah, basically I have no idea what I'm doing half the time. Let's see here. Let me go over here. Over here. Yeah, I really don't know what I'm doing. But as long as we're collecting materials, that's okay, right? Yeah, sure, whatever. But I want to go back here. Can we make anything? We don't even have a wrench or a chisel. But we're not even looking at this anyway. We want to make some cheat sheets. And cleaning maestros. So, triangle ruler. Is that from the science room? Monokuma photo album? I don't know where that is. Oil paints, art room, electronic table, pen light. Pen light? Is that from the music room? Silver spoon kitchen? Iron plate? I have no clue. Antiseptic solution. Venus flytrap garden. Whistle. Yeah, I can't really tell where these come from. Binary converter. You know what? Forget about the Greek statue. We're just gonna keep collecting stuff. Hopefully, I'm not sure. Soccer? Go to the garden, Mondo. Oh, it kind of tells you some of the things that you can get from there. I guess the list depends on if you found the item before or something. Oh, we definitely need more people in the library for the photo album. Yeah, whatever. Too much thinking. Let's just go. We gotta be really diligent in making sure that Makoto in particular doesn't get too fatigued. Because if he passes out, then we lose 3 days. That's 3 days of free time. Yeah, let's go meet with someone. Why would we want to spend time alone, seriously? So we're done with Sayaka, right? Because her report card is full. Oh, nice star. No. The thing I remember about Makoto most from junior high was that crane that got stuck, and he helped get it free. I'm so busy these days, I don't have a boyfriend, don't even have a crush, although there is someone I'm interested in. Stares at me. Wow, she's really straightforward. Well, anyway, I guess that's time for Leon then. Leon! Wait. Who died next? No. Muguro died next, so let's go to her. Let's spend some time together. I'm not sure how to use the trip tickets yet, so let me know if you have any thoughts on that. Maybe I'll just spend it randomly? Oh, are you asking me out on a date? You're such a little cutie! I guess I went on a date with Junko. Honestly, I really like Mukuro's persona here. I don't really know if it's really her, or is it her pretending to be Junko, or what this is, but I like this kind of attitude. Yes! The funny thing is, if you look at Mukuro's list of items that she likes, there's stuff like, oh, kitten hair clip, rose in vitro, golden airplane, and then you have rations! That's obviously off, right here, rations! Military rations! So that's a little bit of a tip-off, I guess. Yeah.
So
Minamakoto, you didn't just give it to me just to be nice, did you? Yeah, I want to date you. That's exactly why I gave it to you. Well, whatever. Works for me. Yay! God, I'm seriously so freaking bored. I'm gonna die from being so bored. I'm infected! I've got terminal boredom disease! Oh, please don't tell me about being bored, cause... yeah, I met your sister and... she... being bored kinda caused a lot of problems in the world. Is it really that bad? I just hate being bored. Hate it. I never noticed how much I hate it. But once we got trapped in here, it finally hit me. That's pretty recent. I'd rather be living homeless on the street than stuck in here. Homeless? Yeah, you know, like the hobo life? I've done it before, you know. Oh, when you were in the army? You have? Yeah, it's a long story. And now you're a model? Yeah, that doesn't add up. Well, that's a long story too. How many long stories do you have? Seriously, if I had to choose between staying here and being homeless again, give me the street. I guess I can understand that. I mean, you're probably in more danger here than there. Oh hell no! Homelessness is totally dangerous. You never know when a pack of wild animals might show up. Wild animals? Oh, I don't mean literally. I mean people who attack the weak, people who want to hurt you. The world's full of animals like that, you know? But I think having to live like that made me way stronger. Yeah, true. Hearing someone with actual experience talk about it really has a lot of weight to it. Sorry, that kind of got weird, huh? All I was trying to say is... when the hell are we gonna get out of here? Hey, whatever dumb bastard trapped us in here, are you listening? When are you gonna let us out? Aw, that's... I wish we got to know her a little better. Just tell us what we gotta do to get out of here! Hell, you can even just tell me! I know how to keep a secret. Nothing, huh? Pisses me off. Those dot dot dots seemed like it was hey, remember what happened in the last chapter of the story mode? Kinda dot dot dots. Well, I mean, there's no way they'd make it that easy. But listen, you're not thinking of doing anything drastic, are you? Drastic? Oh, you mean the whole kill someone thing? Don't worry, I can never kill someone. What? Do I look like I would? Do I seriously look like a killer? No, that's not what I meant. Really, you don't. Right? I don't, right? But anyway, are you saying you were worried about me? Gotta say, Makoto, that's kinda cute. You almost killed me with cuteness there. Huh? Come on, I'm just screwing with you. You didn't take it serious, did you? But you know, there's something about you. I don't get sick of talking to you like I do most people. Let's hang out again sometime, okay? There was something playful about the way Junko walked away. I still don't get her. Am I getting played somehow? Makoto, you're getting played by every woman here, so just accept it. Trance! What is that? After parting ways... Yep. So, is it just gonna keep going like this for like... 50 days? Cause that's a lot of days. Oh! Maybe we should start cleaning up soon. Hehe, feel like I could do anything! Okay, Leon is all pumped up. Can we make some of the cheat sheet stuff yet? We can make a lot of random stuff, but not that stuff just yet. Yeah, we're not getting any of the other stuff. Cleaning Maestro, nothing from it. Get Monokuma photo album oil paint. Well, I guess we'll just keep trying as hard as we can. Restores HP. So there's a bunch of random stuff that gives you power-ups or upgrades too. But really, we're looking for cheat sheet and cleaning maestros. It doesn't seem to be happening right now, but we'll keep an eye out. Okay, so Leon is all pumped up. Why don't you go to the, I don't know, go to the data center. Oh, everyone's kind of tired by now. We should let people rest. Makoto, how about you rest? Taka? Clean? Byakuya? Clean? Mondo? Do chill work. Everyone just do some chill work. Don't work too hard. And then I'll, no, actually, we should let more people rest. 3 people rest at a time, is that good? That's kind of few, huh? Maybe let Sayaka rest too, and Kyoko. Because if they rest up, then they'll be more energetic for the next day, so to say. Yeah, everyone just take it easy, okay? Yeah, this should be good. Everyone just chill out, chill out. Okay. There's Byakuya and Taka cleaning the rooms. Oh my god, the cleaning is so bad. Look at how little cleaning they did. This is so bad. I think we need to dedicate more to cleaning. But really, screw all that stuff. Okay, well, like I said, wait, can we look at this? Yeah, I want to know how I'm doing with everyone. What? Sayaka doesn't like me at all. Oh, that must be what I read about how the report card doesn't really matter. The presents don't make them like me more. It's the trip tickets? I don't know. I'll figure it out later when I look at the guide again. I think we need to make it so that the bar is full if we want to get the endings. So, let's continue on with Junko until we max it out. Look, she has a different tie compared to the actual Junko, not a Monokuma tie, because that would be a dead giveaway. Let's spend some time together. Ooh. Yeah, I'm asking you out on a date. Yeah, I'm a little cutie, okay. Junko and I grew a little closer today. Yes. You like, what is it? Kitten hair clip, was it? Here you go. Wait, this is the exact same conversation, isn't it? Oh, here we go. Hey, Makoto, can I tell you something? I mean, you, and you alone. Just me? What is it? My true intentions. Oh? Huh? To be honest, I'm kind of fed up with all this. We're all ultimates, right? So we get carried away and rush face first into stuff. Even I have to wonder if it's okay to live like that. Are you thinking of quitting modeling or something? Huh. You know how... I know Mukuro was a part of the Ultimate Despair, but... we don't really know much about her, but what she's telling me right now, I get the impression that she was kind of going along with what Junko said, but not really into it. Dreams are meant to change as you grow up, right? Depending on where you're at, kindergarten, elementary school, junior high, high school. But I've had the same dream since I was a little kid, and I've been rushing toward it ever since. So I've never really had time to think all that hard about my dreams. But what's wrong with that? It just means you still feel the same way about it, right? That's what I used to think. But if it doesn't change, your possibilities can't grow, right? That's how new opportunities are born. And up till now, I never did that. I never let my dreams grow. All I saw was that one dream. I put everything I had into that one narrow little world. I feel like there's so much more I could be doing when I'm not. I don't like that feeling. So, I think I'm gonna start looking for it. Is it childish of me to think like that? Am I just being a baby? No, not at all. No, of course not. People's feelings change. The only constant in life is change. You're fine. I'm the same way. I'm still trying to figure out what it is I want to do. And sometimes I feel like I'll never find it. I feel like maybe I'll spend the rest of my life looking for it. But I'm not sure it's even about finding it or not finding it. Maybe the important thing is that you're looking for it. Makoto, you actually sounded kind of cool just now. No, that's not what I was trying to... But you could be right. Getting lost can be a good thing. As long as you're looking for it, maybe that's enough to be happy. Yeah, I'm gonna remember what you just said. Thanks, Makoto. Sure. In return, I promise that if I do decide to kill someone, it won't be you. Don't say scary stuff like that. I'm glad I was able to talk to Junko like this. I think I understand her a lot better now. I feel like maybe we finally become friends in the truest sense of the word. But before I can do what you just said, I gotta get out of here first. So I'm definitely gonna find out how to get out. Maybe if she stopped yelling at nobody about how to get out, she'd find a way. Well, I guess it's okay. She can do things however she wants. Memoirs of a Fashionista. Huh. That's pretty good. Yeah, compared to the usual, hey, how's the weather conversation? That was actually a nice one, because it's one of those ones where you actually get to know the people you're talking to a bit. So that was nice. Okay, two report cards down.